Completely You're very cute, young sir. What sort of things do you write?
I write plays.
What kind of plays?
Unproduced.
I read name plays. At least I think they're plays. Nobody else does.
Oh, you're growing bitter.
Ah, stop sitting in that tonight.
Pounding away at the typewriter. Bloom. Think you have talent? Think you have something to say?
I feel rejected by the whole world.
How do you manage to live?
Well, I get an allowance from my father. Well, after I got out of the army, he gave me a year to try writing.
Boy, and I was feeling sorry for you.
Yeah, I can't help if I'm not poor.
So anyway, Tony, yeah, you're done with Julie. What do you say one of these nights?
Hey, what time is it?
I think it's around 4 a.m.
4 a.m.? Oh my god!
What's the matter?
I gotta get up and go to work tomorrow! I don't know how I'll do it! Go away, I have to sleep!
See ya.
I won't try to work. I'll just take the day off.
Yeah, why kill yourself? I'm sorry.
Good research.
Is there anything I can get for you before I go?
No thanks, I just want to sleep.
Okay, well, if you need me, you know where I am. Just knock on the ceiling.
Oh my god, my letter! My letter! Igor! Hey, Igor!
What is it? What's the matter?
My letter! I nailed the letter!
Oh.
Julian, I wrote him a letter telling him what I was going to do.
What should you do?
What would be the point of killing myself if he didn't know about it? And now that I blew it, he's got to be told before he reads my letter. Igor, you have to call him for me.
Oh, why don't you just call him yourself?
First of all, I'll be sleeping. Second of all, I'm through with him, and I'm going to give him the satisfaction of hearing me cry. Besides, he'll have to call the cops or something.
All right. He's twisting my arm. Behind me.
Thanks, Igor. You're sweet. Can you turn on the radio? It's too quiet in here.
Sure. So, anyway, what do I tell this guy?
Just tell him I'm alive.
That's it? Hey. Hello, Dr. Winston?
Yeah.
I have some very exciting news for you. Tony is alive.
You do it.
Yeah, I do.
there's your mouth, dude.
Not, my mouth is fine. My teeth are.
Oh, that'll go away in 3 or 4 days.
Thanks. Hey, been a lot of changes since I was last here. Very classy.
A few new changes. New carpet, new painting, soundproofing.
The hell's that? Looks like a jet.
Oh, that's a stereo. These guys become a very important part of modern dental therapy. They say it's soothing to the dentist.
At your price, you can afford hyphens in person.
Mr. Creek, this is a very sensitive instrument.
All right, I hardly touched it. But I do have the right if I so wish. After all, as a patient, I pay for that thing. I really do.
You should.
Julian, I feel insulted. It isn't as if I was planning a mistake yet.
It isn't as if you were planning to pay me either.
Well, I figure you can make it up on your other patients.
Mr. Durant is waiting, doctor.
Mr. Durant, frozen boots.
Boy, I'll bet you soak up plenty.
Shh.
Did you get the soundproofing?
Doctor, I'm going to get the door. You're already running very late. Very late.
Thank you.
Very efficient.
Oh, come on. I always figured you'd have a nurse who was a nurse. Julian Winston. Bachelor. Connoisseur.
Miss Dickinson is my assistant for the very reasons you complain about. She's efficient, devoted. She's like a wife. A good wife. She takes care of all my needs during the day. And at night she goes home to her home, and I with no cares, no problems, go to my girlfriend. Arrange my life the way I like it. Thank you.
Did you say your girlfriend? Used a singular girl. One girl.
Oh, I didn't tell you. It's been a year now.
But you, Julian Winston, captain of the basketball star, a different girl every night. Boy, in a week, guys, on the debating team used to envy you.
You guys talk too much.
Girls. Parade. Frank. Sally. Oh, Sally. Frank.
Frank!
Sally's brother! He nearly killed you. Boy. Managed to duck out on all of them.
RBI, my hero worship, quite sweet, but Tony's changed all that.
You know, Julian, with a little moral courage, that's what Billy's meant before.
Tried to find him. Take last night. I deliberately broke a date with Tony, made a date with another girl, an airline stewardess, Swedish blonde, tall, built. Went back to her place, had a few drinks.
Yeah.
So she came to the
shop. Doctor, room is ready.
Oh, thank you.
Come on, you can't be hanging like that.
Dr. Winston, I'm so sorry I was late.
Oh, that's all right, dear lady. But I hear you've been very naughty. Horrible.
Yes, so. Hi, my job. Well, I only had one.
One too many. Outside the fact that Cardinals are bad for your teeth, think how they get rid of those splendid hips of yours.
Isn't he your dentist?
Great, isn't he?
Great. He's a magnificent dentist, but he would have made a simply marvelous obstetrician.
Obstetrician?
Hot water. Plenty of hot water.
Hey, you didn't finish with that stupid. So, what happened?
Nothing. Only, stopped.
Only she showed up?
No, I suddenly thought of that. Saw her face. Couldn't shake it, so I got up and left. I walked out.
You mean you wasted a whole stewardess? Oh, so many hungry guys.
I'm a man's different girl every night just to make you happy.
You're gonna get married.
Married! Married? Anything about getting married.
You feel that way about your girl.
I feel that way because she's my girl. You never catch me feeling that way about her.
What?
A wonderful office, a wonderful practice, and a great girl. And we're doing all that.
Well, that's a very healthy outlook. What about her?
No problem.
Girls want to get
not. Oh, you see me in a second? She thinks I'm already married.
Julia, you pulled that old stunt on her?
I had to. I wish she could change this whole pleasant life of mine. So I. Over, I had a wife and three kids.
Oh, the three kids is a nice touch.
Like 5 minutes after we met, so everything between us would be open and above board.
Very good. Very good. It's such a big, dirty, rotten line. It has class.
Thanks.
By the way, Julian, I do have a little trouble with a girl. She's very beautiful.
Doctor, Mrs. Durant.
I'll see you next week,
Doctor. Come on, I listened to you about your girl. Let me tell you about mine.
Mrs. Durant is waiting, Doctor.
She's beautiful. Think of Botticelli's Springtime. Beautiful. Great figure. Beautiful eyes.
But her teeth need a little work.
Well, they will laugh.
Doctor, really. Mrs. Durant.
How do you pull the sheet for?
Julian, help me out.
All right. Send her out sometime next week. I'll see what I can do. But don't you know any girls with straight teeth?
Excuse me, Sergeant. Miss Dickinson. The doctor said I could make an appointment for a lady friend of mine.
Let's see, how about 2 weeks from Wednesday at 7 a.m.?
You're kidding. I'm
from asleep at 7 a.m.
I thought you said this appointment was for me.
It is, we're both asleep at 7 a.m. Sorry, I hope I'm not shocking you.
No, but it must be a terrible shock for her. Incidentally, who is paying for the treatment?
Just to put it on my tab.
There's no more room on your tab.
I'll take care of it. It's just that right now I'm in between employment.
Mr. Greenfield, I've never known what your employment is.
I'm an actor.
An actor?
Why do you look so startled? Haven't you ever seen me on television?
Oh, I don't think so.
Oh, come on, Miss Dickinson, you must have seen me.
Really, Mr. Greenfield, I'm sorry.
Everybody has seen my big hit. Woman's in the kitchen crying. Washing machine won't work. And I bust in, carrying my little pool kit, and I say, Madam, your problem is an overabundance of suds. Try Slosho. It contains hexaslosh and all the Slosho suds away. Slosho. What? Never saw that?
I hate myself for missing it.
Well, anyway, what about that record from my job?
Let's see, Thursday the 4th at 5:30 in the afternoon, or is that too early?
Hey, we'll set the alarm.
I'll be right with you, Mrs. Durand. Don't move, and please, keep your mouth open.
No, not yet. It's your sister's birthday. I sent a card, a Zen thing with a card on it. I hope that's okay.
She likes roses better.
I realize that, but they were much too expensive, and, your tailor's called several times. You simply must find time to get it for fittings.
Yeah, I'll try.
You say that all the time. I can't very well go to your place any more than I can go to the barber for you. Which, by the way, you could use...
All right.
Oh, doctor, this can't be personal and confidential.
Hey. Oh, my God.
Doctor, what is it?
I have to go out for a moment.
Doctor, what am I going to tell Mrs. Durand?
Tell her whatever you want. To just get out of it some way.
What do I tell the other patients?
Just tell them anything.
Doctor, what are you talking to me?
Miss Dickinson, I have nothing to explain to you.
Doctor, I know that letter was from a girl. Really, if your girlfriends are coming before your patients...
Miss Dickinson, shut up!
Doctor, you never said that to me before!
Remind me to say it more often.
Doctor! Because
of me?
I saw no other way out.
Oh, God. The biggest bastard in the whole wide world.
Julian, please, you're starting to make a
It wasn't really your fault. I knew what I was getting into. You've always told me the truth.
I should have kept my mouth shut.
But you couldn't, Julian. You're a decent guy, and that's why I've loved you. And now I'm returning you to your wife and children, and I hope you'll be very happy.
No, no. I'm going to make up for that.
Coming here, Miss Dickinson. You are very beautiful, yet you try to conceal it.
Well,
Very successfully, I'd say.
No, that costume doesn't fool me. You see, we black men, we have a great eye for hidden beauty. See, in our country, for centuries, our women were all covered up, long dresses, mantillas, veils, and so in self-defense, black men had to develop an instinct for guessing what was underneath.
Okay, let's see that point. How about Thursday?
Wonderful. Where shall we meet?
This is you with the doctor?
No. I was thinking you and I should meet one of these nights, alone together. Small dinner, candlelight, guitars.
Will you bring your wife?
My wife? You wouldn't like her. Nobody likes her. Now let's take a chance to do my wife.
I can't, senor. You are a married man.
So I'm married. That's my problem. What does that have to do with you? You know, if you were married, I would not be prejudiced in the least. Americans, I still think you're very attractive. What's your first name?
Stephanie. They call me La Brava.
Hasta la vista, La Brava.
La vista.
Come, Senor Sanchez, I can take you now.
I can't take you now.
You made him happy.
I'm glad. Sorry, I ran out on you this morning.
I managed.
Oh, I knew you would.
Oh, you knew I would? Well, I didn't know I would, but I did. Everything got straightened out. I told Mrs. Durant some story about your mother being bitten by a tsetse fly or something. And I made all the new appointments for all the patients.
Don't count on you in a jam.
Yes, you can. Now, doctor, there'll be nothing else when it's straight inside. Doctor?
I was wondering if you're in a hurry this evening.
Why, no, doctor. If there's something I can do for you, I'm happy to stay.
Well, I was wondering if we could have a little talk.
Talk? About what?
It seems to me that I've suddenly realized that we really don't know who each other is. Who is that?
Well, I'm out in the open. I'm at my desk. Why would you want to know?
I know, but at night, you do continue to exist. Who is that? Go on.
Who is that?
Now, go on. I want to hear everything.
Well, I live in Jackson Heights.
Alone?
Yes, well, I mean, no, I live with my mother. We have 3 rooms. Well, actually, 2.5 rooms. We have a dining alcove. A very big dining alcove, so I guess you could call it 4 rooms. That's where we keep the television. Mother and I love watching news while we eat dinner. I like Walter Cronkite, but Mother likes Huntley and Brinkley better, so we don't often need to watch Walter Cronkite.
And what do you do after dinner?
Oh, well, I go for a walk with Frida, my Cocker Spaniel.
Frida? The hell of a name for a Cocker Spaniel.
Oh, Frida loves it. And other times I like to go to my sister's house. She and my brother-in-law and I love to play Scrabble.
Scrabble? That's fun.
Oh, yes, it is. My brother-in-law is very good at it, but he cheats. They also have 2 sons. I'm very fond of my nephews. On my days off, I like to take them to the circus or to the zoo, and other times I like to go to movies. Foreign movies. Italian? I think Marcello Mastroianni seems very intelligent.
And what do you do on your vacation?
Oh, now that's when I change. I break away from everything and go zooming up Cape Cod with Little MG.
Hello?
No, I bring my mother. She's Martha's company. Did you take Frida?
Of course.
Yes, we rent a little cottage by the water.
So he is a real wild bunch, huh?
Oh, yes, the mother even wears blue jeans. You should see her.
I'd love to. But Miss Dickinson, I'd love to hear about your mother and your family, and of course Frida, but what about you? Your personal life, I mean,
You mean then?
Yes. I don't want to pry, but, you know, how many...
Doctor? At the moment, there are no men in my life.
I said at the moment, so there hasn't been before.
Doctor, I'm no sex goddess, but I haven't lived my life in a tree. Oh, you know what?
Oh.
Astounding, isn't it? Yes, terribly in love. It lasted almost 3 years, but...
Oh, I was just thinking of a similar case, I thought.
Oh, yes, I sent him back to his wife and children. And after that, I dated quite a few other men. Very attractive, but... See, they were married, too. Not too funny. I seem to be the type that attracts married men. But quite frankly, I hadn't planned on being an old maid.
Old maid? Oh. You have a long way to go.
Oh, but I'm making very fast progress. Now, doctor, there's not going to be anything else tonight.
Well,
I'm just going to go out and make for dinner.
There was something else I wanted to talk to you about. You see, I really enjoyed talking to you. You're a very rare person, sensitive and generous.
Well, I think I'm okay.
Well, I see that if I ever ran into trouble, I could tell I need to help.
You know that's true.
But sometimes the problem is so big.
Why don't you just help me?
See, Miss Dickinson, you could do me a great service. See, I'm in greatly need of a wife.
Please
let her get something. I only need like 15 or 20 minutes. Oh, I'm telling you, it's all very bad. What I need is someone to play the part of my life.
Someone like me.
Yes, it only would. It wouldn't involve any. And all you'd have to do is go tell a certain someone that you want a divorce. You see, Miss Dickinson, I suddenly decided to get married. Oh, I didn't tell you.
No, you didn't.
Well, I have.
Congratulations.
Thanks. If the girl I want to marry, Tony Stevens is her name.
Oh, how do you do?
Well, she won't marry me until she's met my wife, but she'll sort of be a home wrecker. Is that sweet?
No, Jess, darling.
So all you have to do is go down to the village.
Doctor, I'm sorry. I lies.
No more than I, Miss Stevens. No more than I. I don't know how to get out of this one. You hold my happiness in these two hands.
Doctor, for many years, these two hands that now hold your happiness have handled nothing but your surgical instruments and your appointment book. You've managed to handle your happiness very nicely, but no help from me. Now you want to use me in this disgusting way. Doctor, you tricked me into talking about myself so I would break down. What you did wasn't very pretty. Not very pretty.
You can't get decent help these days.
Have you ever been jealous?
something very attractive on them.
Oh, oh, thank you, my dear.
Truth.
truth is that he was a premature baby, one before we were married.
Oh, I'm wrong. It proves everything.
It does?
Yes, don't you see? You're the woman who gave herself to you before you were married. Isn't that a marriage convenience? It was love.
Tony, has it ever crossed your mind?
She still loves
you. Tony.
And I'd always feel guilty if I did anything to ruin what you guys already have.
Look, Tony, has it ever crossed your mind that my wife wants a divorce just as much as I do, and for a very good reason?
What good reason?
choked up.
There was no reason for your fiancé to spy on me. You know I spend my days off with my nephews. Look, Doctor, if I can't spend my days off the way I see fit, then...
Look,
I'm resigning. It's 2 weeks ago.
You must do this one. Not only as my dear friend, but as my nurse. It's your professional duty.
Professional?
Yes. This situation with Tony is affected. Do you know what happened today? I've heard Mrs. Delaney. I caused her pain. I have never heard one of my patients before.
Well, I did predict your disintegration.
Look, Mr. Kennedy, you played the part of my wife once. You can do it again. You did enjoy yourself. Admit it, Mr. Kennedy, you did enjoy yourself.
Right, it wasn't so bad.
Now here's your chance to play it again. You can't give up this role, just one more performance. It's like actors playing a great Joan of Arc for only one night. Besides,
no, it's just that between the roles, Joan of Arc has a happy ending.
do it for me? Just this one last time, please.
Fine. Go see Tony. Tell her I have a boyfriend.
No, she has to see you with me.
In the flesh? Well, how are we going to do that?
I don't know. Have your friend, you could ask. How much brother love?
Look, you leave my family out of this. You want me to have a boyfriend? You find me one!
Be someone we can trust.
Hey, what about the old Senor Sanchez? Cat's already asked me out on a date.
Senor Sanchez made overtures to who?
Not overtures, just a tiny little bossa nova.
Miss Dickinson, you know I don't like that sort of thing going on in the office. It can mean...
Look, Doctor, why don't you stop worrying about me and start finding me a boyfriend?
Julian, I gotta see you right away. I might keep you killed.
Not him. No, not him!
Why not him?
No!
Why does she hate me?
No, hardly wrong. Ron, she's very interested in you. So, how about your girlfriend Tuesday?
I do for free.
Good evening.
see you in a nightclub. You turned into quite a swinger, my dear.
Well, you see, Tony, Julie never realized I couldn't go out much. She was a little much too young.
By the way, Mr. Greenfield.
Yes, it is.
How do you like
Silver?
Grilled, medium rare.
Oh, my. Oh, that's a very funny joke, Mr. Greenfield. But the kind of joke which comes from a man hiding a profound emotional feeling. Deep down, you love children, right?
Really one of the gamest women I know.
Stop it, Tony. Now, who's that?
Jack look over and get him.
I'm not nervous.
work as usual. I'm sure you'll be very happy.
Oh, you mean it's my professional duty?
Yes. I didn't mean those things I said. Well, yes, I did.
Yes, you did.
Yes, I did. You're afraid of life, afraid of love, afraid of intimacy. You're scared of that damn Cocker Spaniel of yours.
Well, afraid of that 22 puppies!
Hey!
Hi, Julian. What are you doing here so early?
Two patients called and canceled, so I now am free. I thought I'd come by and see you. Hey, you always stand like that?
Like what?
Let's just say if any customers stand where I stand, they'd with quite an angle.
Oh, that. Nobody here looks. Most of our customers are classical. What's that?
Oh, it's a surprise.
What is it?
Well, I wanted to wait till your birthday, but I couldn't.
God, what could it possibly be in such a big box?
Yes.
Black leather slacks.
Black leather slacks.
A suede coat?
Can't you think bigger than that?
What could it possibly be? I've got to see. My God, a mink stole! A mink stole! Oh, and a card too. As ever, Julian.
I wanted to say to my sweet, adorable, delicious Coney, but I got it wholesale from a guy, so.
You had to be discreet.
And it still cost me a bundle.
It must have.
You haven't said you liked it yet.
A mink stole! A mink stole. Julian, are you trying to tell me something?
What makes you say that?
You've done something bad. You want me to forgive you?
Now, tell me. It's nothing like that.
I don't know, Julian. You're not a stingy man, but you're no dining gym spender either. I don't know.
Well, honey, there is something I want to talk to you about.
Thought so.
You see, there's something that's been bugging me lately.
It's about your wife.
Yeah.
Don't be nervous. I think I understand.
You do?
Last night, you and she, for old time's sake.
Don't tell me that's absurd.
It's okay, Julian. After all, it was I who told you to be nice to her. Of course, it was up to you to decide how nice.
Oh, nothing like that. Will you let me talk?
Hey, Julian, go ahead and talk.
I have to get this off my chest. You see, my wife Stephanie is...
Yes? Excuse me, miss. Do you have the hindness protect? Go ahead.
The hindness protect? Behind it?
You wouldn't like it.
I love hindness.
Pest? Go ahead, sweetheart. You were saying?
Stephanie is.
Come on, Julian, let's have it. You know me, I can forgive anything but a lie.
Forget it.
No, we're not going to forget it. Okay, you've got a problem with Stephanie, right?
Forget it.
Let's see. She drinks.
No.
She's a kleptomaniac.
No.
She does drugs.
No.
Well, there's only one thing I know of that a husband would be ashamed to talk about, and Stephanie is no nymphomaniac. I guessed it? And that's what you came here to tell me? Wow. Go ahead, honey, give me all the details, and I promise we'll never talk about her again.
Do you mean that?
Absolutely. We're through protecting her.
It's too painful to talk about.
Yeah, well...
My wife, Stephanie, she's a slave to her desires.
A very sweet way to describe it, isn't
it? Well, now you know the truth.
Julian, I'm sorry. I have been dopey. It's just that all this time I thought your wife was in love with you.
How about this? How about tonight? I'll pick you up around 7 and we'll go and have some fun.
Okay, Julian, but if you don't mind, I'm going to send your wife your breakfast.
Why would you do that?
Well, it's just I felt sorry for her last night. I'm still gonna send him to her if you don't mind.
Oh, you're the most thoughtful woman I know.
Hi, Igor.
Hi there.
I wear.
What are you doing here?
Well, I was just wandering around and I thought I'd drop in.
Wandering around? What about your work? Say, you know, I haven't heard your typewriter pounding lately.
That's because I haven't been pounding. Can't seem to get it going.
Something on your mind? A girl.
I'm fed up with girls and stuff like that. I seem to want to mean something else. But I don't know what. Boy, I wish these records were breakable.
I know exactly how you feel.
What are you so upset about? You're madly in love.
I guess so.
You guess so?
Look, Eugene O'Neill, we're not talking about me, we're talking about you. We can't let it break right.
go to pieces. What are you doing tonight?
Nothing. I just kind of thought I'd stay home and be depressed.
Nonsense. You're going to have dinner with Julian again.
Boy, Julian will love that.
Oh, come on. He'll be happy to have you. After dinner, we'll go out dancing.
What is that?
It's me. I'm Julian. How do you like it?
Turn around. Very nice. You know, I look like my Aunt Beatrice.
I want a black leather slack.
Much more tasteful.
Poor Julian. I thought this was pleasing.
Well, that kind of character gets his kicks out of draping his women in mink.
That's very unkind. Boy, when I think of all the women who give their souls for this, and here I am, not really wanting it. Hey, Igor!
What?
Here's my chance to move in. I'm gonna send his wife these records. I'll send them to me.
Hey, you're the most ridiculous, wonderful kook I ever knew, but Mrs. Winston's never gonna accept the mink stole from you.
What's the matter? She'll love it. Where's that car?
Oh, doctor, in pain. Oh, it's wonderful. Simply marvelous.
love beautiful music.
The music. What a way of putting it. Oh, the music. Thank you, Doctor. Oh.
Thank you.
that thing flying around there, it might get stolen.
It is. Certainly works fast.
Yes, she certainly does. It's silly, don't you?
Can't believe she's already found somebody else.
You want to know this?
That woman over there has stolen your wife.
Not bad at all.
Thank you.
Yes, she's surrounded by her husband, her ex-boyfriend, and her new
husband. She's surrounded by her like
ex. Oh, never mind that.
No, it's a compliment. She's very beautiful.
Igor, this is new. You go for the older one.
So do you.
Let's dance.
All of a sudden you want to dance.
Are you coming or not?
Come, boy.
Last night you were doing pretty well, I mean, glory-wise. sure my pipe will help.
Well, maybe. They started filling all these lovely, noisy people. Everyone's buying those drinks and hanging around and it's about 4:30.
Yes?
No, no. Oh, what are the musicians? Why a big bash in this place?
Why a big bash?
It's a party. Dancing.
Pot! Do you know that marijuana is the pot of marijuana? You mean smoke it?
Oh, just a puff of these horns.
What a great monster.
No, Dr. Frankenstein, y'all, this was no creation of yours. This was me. Me experiencing things I've never experienced before, and having a hell of a goddamn good time at it.
Well, I think you said it was a hell of a nerve.
Oh, my.
What?
Oh, Senor Sanchez. Forgot all about him.
But you were with Senor Sanchez.
No, you see, the beach.
The beach?
Oh, yes, after we went to the musician's house, we were going to take a long ride out to Coney Island and watch it somehow.
You sat on the beach on your new moon star.
Little sand one, we're inside on you, talk to fly on.
Lie on! Now! Were you sitting or lying, Miss Dickinson?
I don't remember. I was too busy watching sunrise.
Well, Senor Sanchez.
Oh, I'm
trying to think.
He forgot about him.
We? Who's we? You mean this whole night of debauchery was spent with that hippie?
It wasn't debauchery. He was not a hippie. He's just warm.
Oh, well, someone kissed you on the neck.
Yes, he did kiss me on the neck, and after I liked it. I've lost a lot of time, and I'm no longer going to be afraid of life. Oh,
I'm in love. Well, I'm sure my departure helped you and Igor get along just fine.
Oh, yes, my departure did help. Oh, he's just wonderful. You know, Jim likes the things, but... And they did help. It was a spark. Electricity. Oh, it was my electricity.
Well, if you brought along your own batteries.
Don't go! I'll kick you!
Oh, now, Miss Dickinson. You spent a gay, wild evening at Winter Head, I'm sure. Well, the farm was done. It's a little flirtation, right? It's all buzz. It's just a little flirtation. All right, it was a bad passion, but at least you didn't, that is, you didn't,
Doctor, you always treat me like an antiseptic sphincter. Why don't you just ask me if I went to bed with him?
All right, then go to bed with
him. Let's tell your business.
Now listen here, you must tell me.
My wife.
A husband's bride, let's not forget you're still my wife.
And no more, I want a divorce after all the years of misery I've had with you.
Years of misery?
Oh, yes, let's not forget the mysterious phone calls. All the pretty pages you treated free. All the hairpins on the couch. Your handkerchiefs all smeared with lipstick.
Now, wait a minute.
And your wallet.
My wallet.
Oh, let's not forget your wallet. All stuffed with pictures of girls in bikinis.
It goes through my wallet. You went through my wallet. That's the most immoral thing I ever heard in my life.
Don't you talk to me about morals, you libertine. On your wild weekends in East Hampton.
How do you know about my wild weekends in East Hampton?
You spy on me.
You had me followed. You want war? You can have it.
Good!
I'll tell the whole world about your drunkenness, your marijuana parties, your orgies on the beach. You want a divorce? You want a divorce? No, Miss Dickinson, it's all right. You want a divorce.
I know what I'm going to be your nurse, your wife, and your personal slave.
Miss Dickinson, you walk out the door, don't ever think about coming back.
What, do you think I am, a masochist? You want a divorce? Fine. You'll never see me again. That was the children, too.
For the 10th time, nothing happened.
I have a right to know. She's my fiancée's wife.
I really just don't want to discuss it with you, okay?
Well, I don't really have to ask. I have
talk. I enjoy talking to her about my work and about myself.
Now, it's a rare treasure when you can find one that you can talk to.
Are you implying you cannot talk to me?
Well, as a matter of fact, I can. Whenever we talk, it's you who's always doing the talking and talking about you and that old silly, ridiculous dentist.
Don't talk that way about Julian. He's a good man.
He may be good enough for you, but sure as hell not good enough for his wife.
You should know what I know.
I know what I know, and I know that she's good looking, she's smart, and she's very happy.
Aha, then you did want to.
Want to what?
No evil.
You are a filthy, disgusting juvenile mind.
Igor, it's for you.
Oh, hi, Stephanie.
You two would prefer I could go late in the icebox.
See that, Sonia? I'm here to talk to you, not Igor. Now, Igor, if you don't mind.
Well, I don't know if I should. I mean, if you two are invited. Sorry. I'll be the best one.
And I used to worry about you.
So you see, Tony, that's what caused all these problems. I know you're expecting Julian, and I don't want to run into him.
Stop, boy.
You, Igor, that child.
Like I said, I'm not here to talk about Igor. I'm here to talk about Julian and me.
He sent you?
No, I'm here to straighten out this whole mess on my own.
Well, it's about time. Now, what about you? Are you keeping him or not? Can I take him or can't you spare him? I have to know.
Well, there's something else you need to know first. Sit down. You won't have so far to fall. No, I have no patience with people shilly-shallying about these things, so I'm going to get right to the point. Julian and I...
I know what it is. You're crazy!
I don't think so. Where did you ever get a crazy idea like that from?
Crazy? Not for the swinging Mrs. Winston.
Well, I'm not Mrs. Winston. I'm
Miss Dickinson. Miss Dickinson? You, the old maid?
Yep, that's right.
That's ridiculous.
Oh, that's what I think. Now, Tony, I hate to be the one to have to tell you this, but...
Wait a minute. Let's be calm. Don't get nervous. You're Miss Dickinson, Julian's nurse, right?
Right.
Then who is Mrs. Winston?
That's a very good question, because, Julian's not married.
No, no, wait a minute. This is a trick. You're trying to confuse me, so I'll do something, and you'll get taken to yourself. Along with Harvey and Igor and...
This would be a shock to anyone here, especially someone like you with your youth and
dirty son of a bitch.
That's pretty much it. Now look, Tony, I didn't come here to marry Julian. I know you're expecting me.
Why did you suddenly decide to come here to a message now?
Well, let's just say that Miss Dickinson is a leader. She tries to tidy up before she goes. Tony, one of these days, Julian's going to come to you on his own and tell you the whole truth. And when he does, try to help him. Accept it. Well, try to.
A man who lies cannot love.
Now that certainly sounds like something out of a fortune cookie.
Dirty married bachelor. Igor! Igor!
What do you want? I'm trying to work.
Come quickly. I need you right away.
All right.
Tony, what is it? Well, what'd you want?
This is what I want.
What about Julian?
You're right.
Are you using me to punish Julian?
What about Julian?
All right, but after this one, I want a complete explanation. The door! It must be Julian. You were using me! You little troll! I'm getting out of here!
He's out there! There's no way you can go!
I'll hide in the bathroom then!
Well, that's gonna look even worse. Suppose he wants to wash his hands.
He's a dentist. They're always clean.
Hey, but you never answered the door. What were you doing?
I was
buy your clothes?
Okay, I was sailing my boat.
Oh, come on. Not today. Today, all your help will understand.
What do you mean?
I'm going to tell you something.
You come and tell me the truth. Sweetheart, if you come to tell me the truth, you are here to tell me the truth. Don't worry, sweetheart. I promise it will be all right.
Well, here it is. My wife, Stephanie, she no longer wants this divorce. Try to come out of here. Not feeling sick about this.
So am I. Poor dear. Now let me see if I can get this straight. Your wife has now changed her mind and now refuses to give you your freedom.
Isn't that unbelievable?
When did she tell you this?
This morning. I fought like a tiger. I roared and ranted and raged, and I pleaded. Offered her the silver, the car, the house, the kids.
That.
my mother.
When I left that apartment today, it felt like an idiot. But only an Igor, you know, caught in her bathroom wearing a diaper. So I got up, I walked out of there, and walked down the stairs, and I suddenly thought to myself, Julian, thank God that's over. Now you can go home to your wife. So I stared down the hallway, seeing myself, and then, bam, did it. When I got home, didn't be anyone there. And when I got to the office, there wouldn't be anyone here either.
Stinking. Stinking. Oh, that's perfect. I'm sorry, Doctor. Very nice.
Stephanie.
Oh, Doctor.
I think I'm going to kiss you.
Oh.
Unless you have any objections.
Right.
Well, I kissed you.
Yeah.
I'm going to do it often.
Oh, me too.
It's funny, isn't it?
Oh, wait. It is, isn't it?
I guess I always kind of thought of you as my wife. Hey, we don't even have to get married.
Yeah, this is a matter of form.
You know, I'm going to need a new nurse.
Doctor, after all the trouble I've run through, I'm not going to let another old man crack at you.
After all the trouble you went through, what about me?
You?
Tell her I've been grounded.